ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. I bear witness that none deserves to be worshipped except Allah, the Almighty, the Most Gracious. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his final messenger. My dear brothers and sisters, today in this Friday sermon, we are, inshallah, I want to emphasize one word. That is the word of the occasion. Today, we are already in the middle of fasting, the month of Ramadan. So our topic during Ramadan, most of the discussions will be on Ramadan, about Ramadan and related to Ramadan. So it is fasting and the month of Ramadan. Mostly, we talk about in the month of Ramadan when we are fasting to be polite, to watch our words, our statements, and look at everything before we step into it. So we advise each other in this month more about the ethics, the morality, and having good behavior. But our problem, usually what we witness, is that right when Ramadan is over and we stop fasting, then we go back to our previous situation, which was backbiting, tattletelling, talking nonsense, all those things. And then that made us to make to our Islam to be limited within this month. In the month of Ramadan, that we say this is the month of Ramadan, this is the month of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So everything is for this month. But the rest of 11 months, we are free. That is how our behavior is going. Now, like what we see currently in our cultures, all Muslims, we focus on this month only. What makes this? To the best of my analysis, I feel that we need to learn the definition of the terminologies in the first place. Then from there, when we define each term, then we can know how things are and how our worshiping should be. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this verse, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah the Almighty is saying, oh, you who believe in Allah, كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ, fasting is written upon you, is prescribed upon you, is mandated upon you. So what is that? Now we have to get the definition of these words. The key word of the whole discussion and the whole topic is the word siyam. So unless we know the definition of siyam, then we are subject to making mistakes from time to time. Then in order to make sure that we are free from those mistakes, let us define siyam. I will start now from the beginning of these words, the ayah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Ya ayyuhal ladina. Ya is in Arabic is called Ya unida. It's a calling, but it's a word used for calling. So Ya means calling out loudly, strongly, with emphasis. That's how you call someone. If there's a crowd of people and you want to get the attention of one of them, you get the name of that person and you call that person out loud. And if ten others who are in between you and that person, then you are not talking to them. You are looking at that person and that person is communicating with you. So that is communication of one-on-one communication. That type of calling is called call. It's a wake-up call also. Then it is specified to a particular group, not to all people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say, Ya ayyuhan nas, as He says in many other verses, like the one I started with now by reciting. Coming to the topic. So Allah is now emphasizing one particular group of the mankind, saying, yeah, only to this group, oh, you people who believed in Allah, ladina amanu, those who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From there we understand that fasting in the month of Ramadan is not for everybody. For only believers. It doesn't even concern the hypocrite people, those who are munafiqeen, pretend they are Muslim and not. It doesn't concern them. It doesn't concern non-believers. It's only believers. So it is a message going to the believers only. That is one. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyam. Kutiba in Arabic means it is written. Upon alaykum, it is written upon you, but not written as it is in Arabic. Even kutiba is prescribed. So it is you go to your doctor and you get prescription. When you get prescription, it is written for you. Then it is like this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you look at the English translation, most of them they use and. Fasting is prescribed upon you. So it's a prescription. Then is prescription something bad or good? Is it something useful for us or for others? Then this shows that fasting the month of Ramadan is not something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting pressure on you. It is not mandatory, which you must do it without any reason. It is mandatory, but it's a mandatory which is benefiting you. It's your own interest. So when you go to the doctor, you get the prescription, it's your own interest. The same thing, you got prescription from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is your interest. So when you get the bills, even if it is big, even if it's tests badly, you must take it. You have no choice. That is how the Ramadan is. Even if it is hard for you to tolerate, then you must do it because it's your own interest. There's another topic where you can understand the health. And I'm not talking about it now, The health is a big issue, that every step, every action, every intention which is within the context of fasting is something good for your health, either mentally or physically. Then it is our own prescription. Come to the point now, the key word is siyam. Kutiba alaykum siyam. Fasting is prescribed upon you. What is siyam? What is the definition of siyam? In order to know the definition of siyam, I need to distinguish between two terms that most of the Muslims, I can say 99% of the Muslims, they mix up with these two terms. And also, many Muslim scholars, they take these two words as interchangeable words. They say they show it's the same meaning, both of them, and they are interchangeable. You can use either of them. And it is not that, according to the Quran. In the Quran, there is no word, it doesn't show like two, three words with the same meaning. It becomes repetition, it becomes redundancy, it's not even, it's not good. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is perfect. Each word shows a meaning. The verses, most of the verses translate each other. Then one verse is talking about one issue, the other one is talking about the same issue, but in a detailed way. It elaborates more. Oh, this verse tells just the highlights, and this elaborates, and this makes relates it to another topic. So then you bring, you combine all of them, and you get the full meaning. But when it comes to terminologies, words, each one gives it its own meaning. But again, they can come together in one way or another. Then the two words are siyam and saum, that I want to demarcate between these two words. The saum and siyam, Allah has mentioned them many times in the Quran, and if you look at those and the context of each one of them, then you figure out that the two are giving you two different meanings. The word siyam is much related to the physical part of your body. Your stomach, your belly, your tongue, your body, all that, it is physical matter. Siyam. More focused on siyam is physically related activities, which is something that you make it an action. Where soul is related to psychological part of your body, your emotional, your psychological parts of your body, and it is more, it's not by, it doesn't come with action mostly, but verbally. So soul is more about verbal communication and verbally speaking, the way you speak. Siyam is what you do about the eating. That's linguistic. In terms of legality, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this siyam. In all the verses, if you read where siyam comes, it relates to eating and drinking. So siyam is like imsak, that you hold on yourself from doing something. So that is self-holding, self-control, which is more about activities. This siyam, as you see from this verse and the following verses, it tells about eating, drinking, sex issues, and those things which are more like eating and drinking and desires. Where soul is about communication. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the case of Maryam, the mother of Jesus, peace be upon him, Allah says, فَكُلِي وَشْرَبِي وَقَرِّي عَيْنًا. فإما ترين من البشر أحدا فقولي إني نذرت للرحمن صوما فلن أكلم اليوم إنسيا. الله يسعدك. فكلي and eat as much as you can, washrabi and drink, and waqarri ayn and enjoy, be glad and enjoy by looking at your baby. Then Allah saying, فَإِمَّا تَرَيِّنَّ مِنَ الْبَشَرِ أَحَدًا. If any of human being, today if you see any human being, and they try to communicate with you, tell them this. فَقُولِ إِنِّي سَعِدٌ إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا. Say to them, إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا. I vowed fasting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today. Means today I'm fasting. And this is the promise that I have taken from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that fasting, Allah is telling us first of all that she should eat and drink and also fulfill her desires, that is gladness and enjoyment. All that is about siyam. But then Allah is ordering her to say, I'm not talking to you people in the way that you have an argument and unlimited discussions, but I'm fasting. Means I'm holding myself and controlling myself by from all kinds of irrelevant discussions, irrelevant talks, irrelevant ways of addressing people. So then this is soul. Allah is mentioning that in the form of soul. From there, let's look at the ahadith also, where here Allah says, the following ayah, the ayah that I have just recited, after two ayahs, you can see where Allah says, أُحِلَّ لَكُمْ لَيْلَةَ الصِّيَامِ الرَّفَثُ إِلَىٰ نِسَائِكُمْ هُنَّ لِبَاسٌ لَكُمْ. At the end, Allah says, ثُمَّ أَتِمُّ الصِّيَامِ. Then, complete the fasting. So, still Allah is repeating the word siyam. That siyam, when it is combined with the soul, it becomes full fasting. According to the sentence, when you look at all these sentences, you can see soul and siyam are two separate terms, but bringing them together makes full fasting. And that is where you control, you first of all, you control your desires. You get the intention, number one. Control your desires, and desires, number one, shows you about eating. So you abstain from eating in the daytime, from drinking, from having sex and so on. And all that when you stop, the one which is parallel with it, not as a secondary, but it's parallel with it, is so. That so is that you control your mouth. Say only when it is necessary. Only when it is really necessary. The words that are necessary. Only. And again, say only good words. That is how you make soul. But soul, the difference between siyam and soul is that soul is not limited in the month of Ramadan. Soul is all the time, throughout your life, you must be in soul. But only in the month of Ramadan, you are in siyam. Where is the evidence? Is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ahzab, إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم. Allah says here the point is والصائمين والصائمات. Allah is talking about the good people and said those who are believers, those who surrender themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be they male or female. Those who tell the truth, male or female. those who are trustworthy, male and female, those who are humble, male and female, those who are who pay the zakat, male and female, and make sadaqat, not the zakat here, it's sadaqat, the charity, male or female. And then Allah says, وَالسَّائِنَ وَالسَّائِنَ and those who perform the fasting, which is not fasting from food, it's fasting from bad words, from like backbiting and tattletelling and all those things. The one who controls themselves from that, be male or female, and also those who say only good words, not say bad words at all. Those who are gentle all the time and have good communication with the rest of the mankind. Those who are nice to the people, those are the ones who are successful. So in all that you can see the soul is something which is all throughout your life you must be in this status of soul, which is that you are protecting yourself. And what makes that true is that Allah saying, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyam kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. Allah is saying fasting has been prescribed upon you as it was prescribed upon those who were before you. And the why, the reason is what? La'allakum tattaqun, so that you may fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the word tattaqun, I remember, I think last month my khutbah was the terminology tattaqun, how to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's a big issue. Then sa'il and tattaqun are together, so that you may stay in the status of fearing Allah, being loveful to Allah, beautiful to Allah throughout your life. It is a kind of training 1 month in a year. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, my point of giving the definitions of these two terms, siyam and sawm, is that we know we should not limit our worship in the month of Ramadan only, but we should know that we are always in the status of sa'im. But siyam is in the month of Ramadan only. Others you can use, there are some extra works often you can do, but this is the mandatory one. And come to the hadith side. It's reported that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, if someone addresses you in wrong, saying bad words to you, assaulting you, or something which is irrelevant saying to you, then all you can say to them is to say, "Inni sa'im, I'm fasting." So that is not limited in the month of Ramadan. It's always, always, if somebody, wrongdoers, if they try to make you talk badly, bring you something, issues that are always taking you to some loopholes of bad things, then easily you can say in inside, I'm fasting from bad deeds, from wrong statements. Very simple. And what is the evidence from that? I guess also the one strengthens is ayah of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. And of the good slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who are gracious, the signs to know someone whether he's biased or not, is that if somebody who is ignorant addresses them wrongly, they simply say to them, they say, salam, they only say to them, peace, which is just like I'm sorry. You just say to them, okay, sorry, I'm not the one who gets involved into these discussions. I'm not in a position of talking about these things. I'm sorry from this, from bad words. So morality, the whole point is morality. To be always in good ethics. That is the soul which we will have it throughout our life, and the siyam is more focused on the month of Ramadan. We get that and terms defined, then from there we can know that our responsibilities in the month of Ramadan and in other months. And Allah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam also says, "Man lam yad'a qawl az-zur wal kadh falaysa lillahi hajatun min an yad'a ta'amahu wa sharabahu." So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the one who did not abstain from the bad things, which are qawl az-zur, false statement, and kidd, and lying, the one who never stopped that before Ramadan, and that was his behavior, and it has been his behavior still, that person, Allah doesn't care whether he lives his food, his eating and drinking and his desires. He's only putting himself in a state of hunger and starvation. He or she is simply starving for no reason. Because in the beginning, the person is not someone who controls his words. And the person was falling into the problems of falsifying, making second against people against each other, and lying and all that stuff. So that kind of person, he's only killing himself in starvation. The hadith there shows that the siyam, the soul, who should be before the siyam. You must be someone who is in good status, good character, who was in the status of sa'i before. Then you come to siyam. And you combine together, that is fully siyam. That's how you make your siyam fully. My dear brothers and sisters, I advise myself and to yourself that we should not be as people before us, people of the book who were before us. Because Allah mentioned in the same verse, I'm still talking about the sentence, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykumusiyam kama kutiba alalladhina min qablikum. Why Allah is telling us, as it was prescribed to people before you? So it was prescribed for the people before us. Why Allah is telling it to us? That means they neglected it. How did they neglect? They divided it, they just took it in wholesale in 1 month, and then they didn't distinguish between Sa'am and Siyam. And from there they keep cutting some parts of it. Where you can see now, people of the Christian and Jewish, they fast maybe a few days, 1 week, 2 weeks, 1 day, 3 days. And in those days, they only abstain from eating meat, only animal diet, the meat and milk. Just, they only become vegetarian in a few weeks, 1 week or less. And that's their fasting. What put them into this situation is that they keep neglecting some parts of the siyam and mixing up with siyam with salt. And then finally they come to this level. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us from that behavior. So in conclusion, I want to say that we should always be in the status of soul, but in the month of Ramadan, add it to siyam, then you complete all your worship in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر يعظكم أن الله يأمركم بعمد بدأ بنفسه ثم أمر بالملائكة ثم أمر إن الله والملائكة يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وأقموا الصلاة